Hello ladies and welcome back to another episode of our Ace Citadella Career Mode. Today we are gonna play away against first place Napoli. We are then having a game against Atalanta Bergamo. Still haven't decided if I will play it because I will have to use my second choice team. So I will have to make the decision if I want to play or not. If yes, then I will play it and that's it. And then I will simulate 2-3 games. If no, then we are also gonna play against AC Milan today. Otherwise, I will of course play against them tomorrow, so I will definitely play, not tomorrow, but next episode I will definitely play against them. But Napoli and Milan will soon be our opponents, Napoli first, Milan of course second. Yeah, if Napoli is winning, they're basically already done, they're basically already through. Still have no idea how we are third, because 12 points is nothing and we really got some bad results, but somehow we are third. And this is my first at home against Fürth. But yeah, we're now gonna use our first choice team against Napoli. If we get anything from this game, I would be quite surprised. But again, we play against bad teams, like the top, like the bottom 3-4, and we drop points after points after points. But you played against Juve, a win. We played against Fiorentina, a win. We played against other big teams. We are winning, or at least drawing, but we are basically almost getting 100% of the points against the big teams. So away against Napoli. They're gonna probably play quite attacking, maybe that gives us the space, and maybe we can actually, for counterattacks and stuff, win again. Quick look at the team. Castells, interesting signing. Hizai, Michael Keane, Zielinski, Martinez, Grassi, I don't know him, Diawara still playing for them, Kasri, Milik, and Sisto. So it's a very good team. There are a few players that I am a bit confused, I'm not sure if they're still playing, like especially Rossi Calderon, Mertens, and all these kind of players. Grassi, I think, and Maman are the only two players I don't know. Decent enough team, definitely the favorites, and yeah, again. If you get a draw, I would be happy. If you lose but play good, then I also would be happy. Yeah, I don't really mind, to be honest. I don't want to take too much time, but there's a story I really want to talk about. I have yesterday played, I had a FM17 session. I'm playing basically only FM and FIFA at the moment, not Rocket League that much anymore. And I have had like a 5-hour session. And I'm in season like 4 or 5 and currently the manager of Reading when I took them like mid-table team in the championship. And we actually wanted to like, I thought the team is probably good enough to maybe even get in the playoffs. It will be hard, but maybe, wait, with, okay. Oh, what the fuck? Maybe I can actually do it. Well, around like 15-20 games before the end, we had a very bad one where we, I think, have lost 6 out of 7 games, 1 draw and 6 losses or so. We were basically done. What the fuck? Why is Ostro there? Charisi. So we were basically out. I thought, okay. At that point, I just decided to kind of already prepare for next season. So overloaned out players. I don't like to loan out players. But I got not in the start of the season. I got there like in the middle of the season to Reading. I joined them in mid in the season. So they loaned out a few players that I wouldn't have loaned out. But I decided to not use them anymore, even if they are really good. To really concentrate on using the talented players and the youth players and stuff to give them some game time, and because they are the players I'm planning with next season. So I really was just looking forward to next season. But then we had a run of eight league games, the last one of that being the second last game. So 8 league games, 7 wins and 6 wins and 2 draws. And suddenly, one game before the end, 6th place is the last playoff spot, we are 8th place with 68 points, 7th and 6th place both have 68 points too, so 3 teams with the same amount of points, and the other team, 2 teams being West Brom and I cannot remember the other team, Bolton Wanderers, and we were all in the same amount of points, but we had by far the worst goal difference. We had like plus 4 or 5, I think one of them had, I think West Brom had like plus 8, 9 and the other team had like plus 20. So we had to get better results than both of the teams. We did win our last game, so which means in the last 9 games, league games, 7 wins, 2 draws, and the other 2 teams actually did lose, and with the last game we actually got the playoff spot. I was freaking happy. I wanted to go to bed, but I just wanted to play like a few games and the season, but then we somehow qualified for the playoffs. So I decided, you know, this session is so good, I have to continue. So what I did is, I did continue. We had to, in the first round, we had, so in the semi-finals of the playoffs, Swansea, third place. We are of course the outsiders. First game, we are playing at home, amazing game. Mirkia maybe, we're actually not playing too bad. First game, 2-1 win. We're winning 2-1, well deserved against Swansea. We were a better team over 90 minutes, conceded a stupid goal like 10-15 minutes before the end from Kai Ihan. But 2-1 win. I thought it's amazing. At 2-1 we could actually get this team into the Premier League, which would be freaking amazing. Now the second leg. Swansea completely dominating us. Definitely having the better team too. 75 minutes in, we had no chance basically. 3-0 for Swansea. We were out. 75th minute. 3-1. Out of nowhere. Our first chance in the whole game basically. 3-1. Suddenly, I thought, one more goal, it's 3-2 and we are going through because of away goals. We are in injury time. 3 minutes injury time. 93rd minute, so the last minute of injury time of this game. We have one last corner, and you guess it. We do score the 3-2. It's like, I don't know, 6 a.m. or so. And I'm just so freaking, I don't know, I just try to not scream too loud. But I was freaking hyped. Because, like, that's just amazing. For some reason, nobody in the playoff system, at least in England, cares about the away goal rule. So, instead of us going through because of away goals, for some reason, doesn't make sense at all. Unfortunately, we had to go into extra time and our stamina was down and they just dominated the injury time. Alex Garcia scored 4 goals for them in extra time. They won 7-3 in the end, so out of 3-2. Even though it was 5-2, and again you could say it's over, but we came back with 5-3. Again, just 1 goal into penalties, but in the end, again, 7-3. But that's one of the... That's probably my best gaming moment in 2017 so far. We are almost halfway through the year. That is definitely my best gaming moment of this year. And because of this, I want to ask you again, right down the top right, would you be interested in FM17 live streams? I could do that. I could do that almost daily. I'm almost playing this game daily. And I couldn't do it now because now we are in front of the start of the season. So I would not just join. You would not just take part or join like mid-season, but really in the start of the season. Would you be interested in seeing these amazing stuff or would you not be too interested? So that took a few minutes, I know. So I will try to not show you too many highlights, I guess, to not make this video too long. But yeah, I just had to tell you that, to be honest. It was just my best gaming moment in 2017, by far. And that emo we lost, but I was so done afterwards. I didn't know if I should laugh, scream, cry, and it was a mix of everything. I couldn't sleep for hours, man. I haven't slept a lot, man. I was so freaking done after that. Okay, whoa. I don't know, guys, we are in the 69th minute, and I actually have to put this in. Oh, Martinez off for Mali. Mali is good signing. I actually have to put this in because this, by far, is the worst game yet in this season. I think when I talked about stuff, there wasn't one big chance, like a few good attacks, but not really a good chance on each side, on whatever side. This was the first shot since I stopped talking about my story, my FM17 story. And it was like an easy, savable shot. So this is, it's good for us. Clean sheet, a draw. They might go attacking. Dennis Kaplan maybe with a chance here. Alright, at least 2 chances, but I'm fine with it. But actually, there was 1 shot basically, I think, in the whole game. Now 2 with Kaplan's. So, very boring game. But so far, a draw away against Napoli, a clean sheet. I'm fine with it, for sure. Okay, another chance. 5 minutes for the end. Second shot for them, but once again, an easy save-up shot. They're actually open. But we somehow cannot do it. Especially this Michael Keane dude is so freaking annoying. He wins every freaking tackle. He never makes a mistake. But now the cross for Zavellas. And even though we are parking the bus. In the 87th minute, our second shot. I don't know, man. This is so freaking weird. Nothing happening the whole game. And then 3 minutes before the end, we are parking the bus, playing away against first place Napoli. And we are the team scoring. Like, what am I even supposed to say about this? Zavellas, I think, just won us this game. Oh my freaking god. Here it is, we'll shoot the ball away. The ref is blowing the whistle, guys. And we do start off this freaking episode with a 1-0 win away against first place. I told you, against big teams we somehow can win. And even though we are still not playing good in this season, compared to at least like last season, whatever. We are still 3rd place and probably not 2nd because of this win. And we got a clean sheet in the 87th minute. I mean, I don't know, but right now, I mean, this highlight from FM was today, on Thursday. And this today is Thursday. Today is just such a weird day gaming-wise for me. It's just such an amazing day. Yeah, we are 2nd place. For now, Milan can still get in front of us. But we are now 2nd place, 1 point behind 1st. All the shit I have to go through, all the things where I say my team cannot get results, we are dropping so many points, we are playing bad, we are probably nobody's scoring enough, and now, for now we are 2nd place. This is so freaking weird. Atlanta, I think that, I mean here I'm 14, we are on 15, so I think I have to, so yeah, I will. It is my 2nd choice team, even though I almost could use my 1st choice team again. Ah, okay, no. I will use my 2nd choice team, I will play against Atlanta today, and I will play against Milan tomorrow, in the next episode, not tomorrow, but not in this one. Okay, here we go, we are playing at home against Atlanta, the 2nd game of today's episode. If you can win this game too, then, I don't know guys, if we win against Atlanta too, and end this episode with an away win against 1st place Napoli, and a win against Atlanta, and we always struggle against them, not sure why. I will actually show you the team, to be honest. Probably not the most interesting one, but Atalanta, because of a lot of talent players. I don't know too many of them. I only know one Radu, he's a left back. I know Caldara, I don't know who the center back is. Like the central center back. I know Adnan. I know Conti. And that's basically it. Leandrinho, that's a nice name. If we win this game too, I would accept a draw here, I would say, because of course we're playing at home, but it is our second choice team and it is Atalanta Bergamo, and we always struggle against them. I think actually we basically always lose. It's one of the teams, I think at least, we get the worst results against, so I don't know. But if we win this game too, then that would be amazing. Of course, I think my 2nd or 3rd time I'm playing with Asker, last time I played with him he was like something in the 40s. And now he's already mid-60. So he has changed already a lot. Last time I played with him, I did like him a lot. He was like below 50 weight and I was like, okay. I was like, not sure. Let's try him out, and I did enjoy using him a lot. Because especially I won every tackle with him. He was not fast and he wasn't able to cross. But I won every single tackle with him. And I said, I don't know what it is, but I love something about him I just love. Now he's mid-60, so now I should be able to see a difference. Okay, all right, we'll see what we can do of this in this game. Another one will win, and I will call this episode perfect. Oh, now they will have the first big chance, and all right, I don't know, that should have been a goal. He had so much space and decides to first touch shoot it. Freaking retarded, this dude, but thanks for that. Thanks for being retarded. I think it's also the first time I'm using Demetrio, who's, oh, but who are you freaking? Why is everybody retarded right now? Here, the Metro, this dude, number 23, our new right back. Not sure why he has the number 23. He shouldn't have the number 23, he should have the number 22. So I will have a look at why he has number 23. Maybe I did mistake somewhere with kit numbers. But what I have to say, yeah, he has a 90 potential. I buy Rag with a chance, and what the f... I asked him to shoot with his right foot long post, and shoots with his left foot straight at the goalie. I feel like right now everybody is retarded on the pitch. Everybody who is on the pitch currently is just retarded. For fuck's sake. But yeah, it's my first time using him. Okay, good attack from them. Yidis with the save. The game is already so different to the game against Napoli. Napoli, there were 4 shots in the whole game. 2 for Napoli, 2 for us. And the last one, the second for us, the 4th one in the game, was a goal. And here they already had like 3 shots, and we had 2, and there's no goal. Ooh, what? Why did he not hit it? That was weird. Casey getting subbed in. Never understand why he's not playing for them, because even though of course I started this game mode quite some time ago, I think like January, we got Chiba with his left foot, he had it on his left foot too. That's just not happening, man. On their side, they have so much space after the corner, and the dude just doesn't decides to not head it, but just give us a goal kick, and then Kuchiba just cannot score. Look at, I don't understand how this is an honor. Maybe no, but you're short as shit. It's just not happening. But I don't understand why Casey is always on the bench. It doesn't really make sense for me. The cross. Not sure what is this. I knew it's gonna happen. And just when I saw that, I asked my player to shoot the ball away, and he shoots it straight up, I knew we're gonna have a P-Pleaser, I think it was, 0.2. What amazing. I mean, this, because the thing is, again, goalkeepers in FIFA are retarded. EA is just so freaking stupid. I mean, I asked my player to shoot it away, and it's really not the worst ball. It's not jumping or whatever, it's just, yeah, slapping slightly. This should not happen. And now look at the Yildiz. The thing is, he has the bigger advantage because he cannot only, he's tall, just like the Psyker. Both can jump, but he can also use his hands. So if he jumps and puts his hands up and catches the ball, the attacker has no chance, because also if the attacker is just pushing Yildiz slightly, the referee straight away give a penalty. So the a free kick. So the only thing Yildiz has to do is jump and get the ball. Well, and what happens? What happens? The freaking attacker is jumping. And now look at what Yildiz is doing. He is doing what a goalkeeper never should do. How can I look at him? That's fine enough. Look at what Yildiz is doing. While the attacker jumps, Yildiz actually dodges. He's falling down. I can actually not believe the fuck, the shit that's going on in this episode. First this crazy story about FM. Then we have first against third. Both teams playing quite attacking. Shit game, no highlights, it's 3 minutes before the end, we win. And now we play this game. 3 million chances, everybody's retarded. And then the long ball. And Yildiz only has to freaking jump and catches the ball. And he dodges. For fuck's sake. And this is why I hate FIFA 17 often. This is why I do hate this game sometimes. Because it's so freaking broken, so shit. Yes, so such a retarded company. Come on, Batuya with the pass, and if this is not a goal, oh, okay. And of course, we cannot score, we have 5 million chances, we cannot score, but as soon as we concede, next chance, go. Utreba has an easier chance with his left foot, but this, with his speaker, I mean, what can I even say? I said this stuff like 5 million times. It's so freaking retarded. Ooh. Again, ooh, what? The fuck is going on? Nice. Oh, the header on the line. Maybe another chance. The shot is unbelievably bad. Oh, it got deflected somehow, which I don't know how. I mean, 11 to 6 shots. How the fuck? Another shot. What is the number 30 doing? What is freaking going on in this episode? What the fuck is going on in this episode? The cross. I have no, how is this 1-0? They should be, we should have scored at least 4 and they should have scored at least 2. This should be at least a 6 goal game, at least. Normally it should be like 7-8 and we have 2 goals in this game and the first one just being completely, I mean, I don't know. I actually don't know what to say anymore. Ref blows the whistle. I don't know, man, what to say about this game. I can just give this game the title and it would say everything completely retarded. But at the end, it is a tour. We got the result we wanted to. We did not get the clean sheet, but who cares? We got the tour. I'm fine with it. I just won't forget this game. That was weird. 9 games in, we are third place. Milan is first place. And I mean, we have 6 and there are a lot of teams with 15. Juve is actually not doing too bad. Might be that Juve is finally getting strong again. We are now going to simulate 2 games. Before that, I will quickly check on the kit numbers because I've seen that, for example, Dimitri number 23 does make sense. The first game we're going to simulate will be against Verona. You can see that a few teams have played already. I think Lazio got a draw. Napoli, I think, has lost again or only got a draw. I'm not sure. And Milan did win. So if we win, we could probably go up into second. Only Milan being better than us. Let's have a look at Hellas Verona. They are currently 17th with 7 points. So we're playing at home, full third first choice team. Third place against 17th. Fourth place. Basically, fourth place against fourth last. They have got 1 point for the last 3 games. We have got 7 points. So if you don't win this, then I don't know. This is. It should be an easy win. And you can see Dimitri with number 12. I did change the kit numbers. I haven't changed the kit numbers after the transfer window. And of course, a few people have left and stuff. So we have took a sign with yellow cards, Zavala scoring twice, so finally he's going, finally. Fernandez getting one back, but we have Panagos getting subbed in and Tokoko with a penalty. Turkoglu scoring, Ekotsuku, Turkoglu with a penalty, then afterwards 4-1. Demetrio and Albayrak in Turkoglu scoring a second two, and it is going to be a 5-1 win. With Tavelas 2, Turkoglu 2, Kokutsuku with a penalty. Nobody injured, nobody with a red card. Just an easy, nice win. No clean sheet, but a good amount of goals. So with the goal difference, we are in front of Lazio. We have the best goal difference in the league with the best attack and the second best defense, third best defense. Roma is actually, I mean, they won the league last season and now they are doing quite shit. They're already 8 points behind Milan. But hey, we might actually fight for a league title this season, guys. Maybe it's just me being good mood, but I got the feeling right now, gaming-wise, not only in FFM, but here as well in this series, where I've had a lot of problems in the start of the season, so like 2 episodes ago, a lot of things are working out. We are getting good results, players are kind of going kind of decently, and on our youth squad, we finally have some very interesting players that I might actually sign up soon in the next transfer window. And here you can see, Jarisse has hit the 78, I think, himself. No, he is hitting the 79. Asuka hit the 66 himself. Things are working out, guys. I'm in some good mood. I don't know the last time I've been in such a good mood while recording an AC Della episode. Okay, the last game will be against Udinese Calcio. They are 6th place, not doing too bad. With 5 wins, 2 draws, 3 losses, have a decent defense and decent attack. 17 points. I could actually play this one. I might actually have to think about it. Well, I have decided, to be honest, yes. Yes, I will play. They're a good team. They're just 2 points behind us. And I did say I will play against the teams who are good in the league. So I will play this one. On the other side, for example, Roma, they have won the league last season. They're an amazing team and we will really soon play against them. But currently, okay, they have the same amount of points, but 1 game more. But yeah, I will play against Udinese Calcio. That's my decision. So the league table after 10 or 11 games, this is the league table currently. We are doing really well. The goal in the season is to... Actually, I would like to go in the Champions League. I think season 6, we should be in the Champions League. So I think my goal has to be in the season to hit the top 3, get into the Champions League. And yeah, Juventus actually doing good for once. Milan finally doing good. Lazio, who have been really bad last season, are doing good. Napoli, who have been down a bit. Udinese, really good. Roma, who have won the league last season easily, are doing quite shit. Some weird stuff. But guys, I hope you enjoyed this episode. It was a bit weird, I think. First the story, then no highlights, then this weird game. But here we are. 3 games in play today. 7 out of 9 points. Really good results too. And I hope you enjoyed it. If so, it would be cool if you could smash the like button. Tomorrow I might already start with episode 1 with Portsmouth. Again, tomorrow or in 2 days, I will start. So you should basically... I would say until Friday, so tomorrow for me, evening. Until then, you have to tell me if you would like me to sign somebody or to use a certain formation or whatever. Because starting with that point, there is a good chance that I have recorded already or that already have prepared episode 1. So yeah, if you want to tell me something, you have to do it soon. Except for this, guys. Please have an amazing day. I will see you tomorrow. Maybe with Portsmouth episode 1. If not, then it's going to be AC Dallas. But I'm like, let's say 90% sure it's going to be Portsmouth episode 1. And yeah, if you are looking forward to this episode, to the next episode of this series, that's what I want to say, then it would be cool if you could subscribe to not miss it. I will see you tomorrow. Bye, guys.